This is a prototype of the new Mach Zehnder camera lens. Apologies on the pronunciation. If it looks unusual, it's because it has this box area that contains a light processing device that has never before been used on commercial camera technology. And today, I've been fortunate enough to be given the chance to test it out. So, what are you about to see? You're probably familiar with Dolly-zoom shots, even if you've never heard that name. They're shots like this, where the subject and background of a shot appear to move independently of each other, as if they're not connected. These shots are creepy and unnerving, and it's no wonder then that one of the first uses of them was for the dizzying and disorienting effects in Hitchcock's movie Vertigo. These shots seem fake, but there's no CGI, there's no green screen, there's no effects in post. It's just the artful use of a camera dolly and a zoom lens carefully choreographed. The dolly moves the camera towards the subject while the lens zooms out, or the reverse. The camera moves away while the lens zooms in. The motion and the zoom cancel each other out at the focal point so that the center of the image appears to remain stationary while everything around it appears to move. The effect I'm hoping to make today is essentially the opposite of that. The background, everything around me, should appear to remain stationary while I appear to zoom towards the camera. I'm going to combine that with carefully walking in place at just the right speed, and it should appear that I'm walking forward normally. All right, so I'm going to go attach this to my camera and we'll see what happens. I can't tell if the effect is working right now for reasons that I'll get into in a minute, but I should appear to be slowing slowly larger in frame, as if being zoomed in on. Right now my camera is using a quantum optical technique to both zoom and not zoom at the same time. Both zoom probability waveforms are fed into the camera and it composites them into this image. In essence, it's able to zoom in on me while at the exact same time it is not zooming in on the entire shot. Like most things in the quantum realm, this effect is really hard to explain in a way that makes sense to the human brain. And I am beginning to regret that I didn't include a cat in my explanation. It's just I'm really more of a dog person. So, will you be seeing this effect in any major Hollywood films soon? Probably not. Due to the quantum nature of the effect, it can only happen when no one is observing it. Right now, on my camera over there, no one has their eye up to the viewfinder. But if I motion for my friend to do exactly that, this happens. The two zoom probability waveforms are collapsing, the camera is receiving two contradictory images, and this is what it does with it. There, he's moved away so the effect can continue. It is unlikely that any Hollywood directors or cinematographers would be willing to give up the ability to monitor their shots live, even to create such an amazing effect as this. I guess the only practical use for this effect is to demonstrate how undeniably weird our world is and how it's constantly finding new ways to surprise us. That said, that is in itself, I think, an idea that is worth exploring.